Now I'm just testing some sodium lamps. Found in the bin, they're still working fine. One is a 250 watt and the other one is a 100 watt. The 250 is still warming up, so yeah, that's cool. While I'm doing this, I have a look for my spare goodies. That's not a fitting. Fuse holder, condenser, that's one igniter, and that's another igniter. If you really get stuck, Larry, I probably can sort you out another igniter. I got some ones. I haven't tested this one, but I'll have a look in the bin over the next week or so, and it's an old, different type igniter, but yeah, I'm not sure if it works. And that is a capacitor. So yeah, I'll give all my lamps a test one, so I always want to be sure that they're working. I'll give them a little tick on the socket, on the E40 socket usually. Interesting, I found my Sangamo S216, which has been running for ages on a dial test run, got stuck. It's supposed to flip over between the 9 and the 0, and it has gone up to the black mark, so the dial is stuck. I'm not going to interfere with it, I just let it see how it goes. So that reading is now versus 42856. And now I've got the email that has been running for a long time. Hang on, because it's hard for me to look through the camera. That's at 6633 nearly. So they're sitting on a duration test. I'm setting up in a little Australian panel here, a ripple receiver, and then Mark 2, I think. I was wrong, it's a Mark 1. And that's 6633 nearly. Email is running like clockwork, it's an extremely good quality meter. Normally when the red zero appears, the small 9 or the big 9 has gone to a little zero more or less, and then it flicks across. I got start on these two devices. Mission. 100 watts, 250 watts. Awesome colors. The 100 watt is pretty quick, the 250 is a bit slower. And turning full brightness now, slowly. De-energize the devices. Yeah, this is quite a bit later. The meter is still jammed. Well, that meter has advanced a certain amount of units. And the email is about 27, 28 units. So, yeah. I'll see if I can free the meter up. I'll give it a tap, usually it seems to free the click, and now it's back in mesh. So these 216s, it's this particular type, is the odd time that the dials can jam. Anyone who knows the name of this track, I love this track, I need to get hold of this. Awesome piece of music. not long after I recorded that beautiful audio track, I found this whole device, this projection TV, and it's complete. It's a Sony FX432M31. It's a monster, a big monster. About 2:30 this morning, and I looked at it, and it is complete. It's got three guns in there, it's got the mirror thing in here. You can see the camera in here. Oh, that's quite cool. And probably lots of files to take out for some future experiments. I have to show that. Oh, it's only giga. I have my redneck incinerator, castle blower. Old 44 gallon tank, it's from a 33,000 volt circuit breaker. Nice and thick steel, and it works like a charm. A bit of forced air. I control the speed of the motor by means of a variac. It's a 3000 rpm motor.
A couple of metering updates. This is the one on the wire in the wash house.
The S216 in the workshop has jammed again, so I need to modify the register on that one. In the meantime, the D3YBD is on that reading versus the Australian Larry's meter, the SDM. It's got quite a few more units. Couple of metering updates in this particular video. Meters on rollover in a very short period of time. 11,000 kilowatt hour. Old lens and gear. I think it features in another video at some stage. Interesting notice with jamming of this meter that it seemed to be next to the one. Oh, it's heavily stuck now. Meter's not happy. That's stuff that needs to be sorted. Scheiße, I just missed this 44,000, the rollover. A couple of attick finds I did today. This is a 2-8 AEG meter with a maximum demand, 3-phase. That will come in the next video. I found also this 2-8 Ferranti meter register. Came out of an old Ferranti meter. Quite cool, the mill that'd be. Featuring at some stage. Washing machine causing a pulsing load on the ammeter. Okay, I've taken this meter off. That needs some work done, and sort out what the problem is. And in the meantime, I've fitted an CL2 meter from Landis+Gyr, and it starts running now. On 50049, and this meter 44001. In theory, it should go three times as fast because that one's wired in series. So it's just rolling over. Just zoom in for it. I'll just stabilize it a little bit more. It's a 30 amp meter running at 35 ampere. Five zero zero five zero six seven five one three.